Good afternoon. Open my ears, Lord. Jesus reminds us that we sometimes hear but don't listen, listen but don't understand. Opening our ears isn't as easy as it sounds. As children, we hear. As teenagers, we hear.
Your curfew begins in an hour.
As adults, we hear.
Cash or credit.
In the water and the word, we hear.
You are loved, my precious child.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Open our ears, Lord, to heed your will for our lives. Help us not only to hear, but to listen and understand with our hearts. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah, the 50th chapter. God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backwards. This week's psalm is Psalm 40, verses 1 through 8, and we will read it responsively by whole verse. I waited patiently for the Lord. He inclined to me and heard my cry. He drew me up from the desolate pit, out of the miry bog, and set my feet upon a rock, making my steps secure. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many will see and fear and put trust in the Lord. Happy are those who make the Lord their trust, who do not turn to the proud, to those who go astray after false gods. You have multiplied, O Lord my God, your wondrous deeds and your thoughts towards us. None can compare with you. Were I to proclaim and tell of them, they would be more than can be counted. Sacrifice and offering you do not desire, but you have given me an open ear. Burnt offering and sin offering you have not required. Then I said, here I am, in the scroll of the book it is written of me. I delight to do your will, O my God. Your law is within my heart. A reading from the book of Matthew, the 13th chapter. Then the disciples came and asked him, why do you speak to them in parables? He answered, to you it has been given to know the secrets of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it has not been given. For to those who have, more will be given, and they will have an abundance. But from those who have nothing, even what they have will be taken away. The reason I speak to them in parables is that seeing they do not perceive, and hearing they do not listen, nor do they understand. With them indeed is fulfilled the prophecy of what Isaiah that says, you will indeed listen, but never understand, and you will indeed look, but never perceive. For this people's heart has grown dull, and their ears are hard of hearing. And they have shut their eyes so that they might not look with their eyes, and listen with their ears, and understand with their heart, and turn, and I would heal them. But blessed are they, their eyes, for they see, and your ears, for they hear. Truly, I tell you, many prophets and righteous people longed to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it.
I'm going to start today's reflection with a poem. A wise old owl lived in an oak. The more he saw, the less he spoke. The less he spoke, the more he heard. Why can't we all be like that wise old bird? That's by an unknown author. Bernard Ferrari writes in the McKinsey Quarterly that the many great listeners I've encountered throughout my career have exhibited three kinds of behavior. Be respectful, talk less than you listen, and challenge any assumptions. These behaviors may be difficult to change for some, but it has been said that introverts are better at these skills than extroverts. Listen. What do you hear? Do you ever sit in silence? What do you hear when you ride in your car, when you exercise, when you sit in a church pew, or talk to your friends? Have you ever told someone good morning and followed that with a how are you today? Do you wait for the response? And if you do, do you listen to the response? Perhaps you have listened to the response from Norm Jones. He says he's grateful. But is it because his response is unique? Because he is grateful? Or because you're a great listener? Now that we have identified your listening skills, and hopefully I have your attention, when and where should you be listening? When is God speaking to you, answering your prayers, guiding you through your next challenge, or nudging you to share your gifts and talents with others? God shows up every day, all day long, and he listens to us. Do you think He gave us two ears and one mouth for a reason. Shouldn't we be listening twice as often as we speak? I wish I could say that I show up every day, all day long, and listen to God. And Craig probably wishes I'd listen to him. But all I can really confess is that I'm a sinner. I am not always the most attentive listener, but I have resolved this year that I'm going to attempt to be better at listening. Nonverbal signs that you may show someone that you're not listening to them have been identified also in Psychology Today. These signs are fidgeting with objects. Have you ever known that person that doodles with their pen? Lack of eye contact? Somebody that's touching their ears, maybe their neck, not listening to you, rolling their eyes, or that back challenging of language, huffing, audible noises, things going on in the room, all signs that they're not listening. Hoda Kotb is one of my favorite co-anchors on the NBC Today show, and she published a book last year called This Just Speaks to Me. It's a book full of quotes and stories she has compiled over the past year. And recently, she has taught me to say, I hear you, and I have received what you are saying to me. Our reading in Matthew today says, not only do we not listen, but we do not understand. Wouldn't it be awesome to hear all that God is telling us every time he speaks, to understand what he has shared, and to be able to say to God, I hear you, and I have received what you are saying to me. In Proverbs 3, verse 6, it says, listen for God's voice in everything you do, everywhere you go. He's the one that will keep you on track. So going forward, I challenge all of us to hear God all day, in your music, in your reading, in your working, in your conversations, and in your silence. Hear him and receive him. God has given you the knowledge to understand him if you take the time to listen. Amen. Lord of all life, when we cannot see the beauty of your creation, oh, I forgot the song is next. I'm sorry, Pam. Go ahead and play that.
Oh.
Let us pray. Lord of all life, when we cannot see the beauty of your creation,
open our eyes that all living things thrive and grow.
When we neglect the poor, the sick, and the grieving,
open our hands to do your work in the world.
When we ignore the cries of injustice in our midst,
open our ears that all will know your love.
When we are hardened against our neighbor,
open our hearts and heal our resentment.
When we are closed to the grace you long to give us, into your hands, gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Go into the world with eyes open to the transforming light of Christ, hands open to serve those you meet, ears open to call of the Spirit, hearts open to the bountiful love of God, and lives open to follow Christ to the cross. The God who opened for us the way of everlasting life bless you now and forever. Amen. Go in peace. Christ is with you.
Thanks be to God.